Alright, what's up everybody? I'm back with some more Pokemon Leaf Green. In the last episode, we took on Brock after finishing up the Viridian Forest, and we completely annihilated him. If you look, my Squirtle only lost like 4 HP in the entire gym. So that's pretty cool. He's also one level away from evolving, so that's going to be pretty cool. I believe there's a hidden item right here. Where the heck is it? There it is. It's only a Pokeball, are you kidding me? Thought it was gonna be like a rare candy or something. But I could have evolved my Squirtle right then and there. Anyways, in this episode we're gonna be heading to the east of Pewter City, the only way to go. And I believe we get the running shoes right over here. Did you check out the museum? I'm gonna say yes, because he's probably gonna lead me over there. If I say no, I don't wanna do that. I lied. Oh, Juicy, I'm glad I caught up to you. I'm Professor Oak's aide. I've been asked to deliver this, so here you go. And we get the running shoes, finally. In all the other games, like the later games, we get them at the beginning of the game, which is a lot more helpful. And I switch my shoes, press the B button to run. But only when there's room to run. Well, I must be going back to the lab. Bye-bye. Bye-bye now. There's a letter attached. Dear Juicy, here is a pair of running shoes for my beloved challenger. Remember, I'll always cheer for you. Don't ever give up. From Mom. Wow, Mom, embarrassing me. Okay, Route 3, and we already ran into a trainer. Excuse me, you looked at me, didn't you? Yeah, what about it? Oh, why are you standing in that pose like that, huh? Kind of suggestive. For this little kid game, Pidgey level 9. Okay, I'm just gonna use water again. There's gonna be a ton of trainers on this route right before Mount Moon, so I'm probably gonna like only show like 2 or 3 of them, because it would take forever if I did show all of them. I believe there's like 7 trainers here, something like that. Don't want to show them all, but looks like we leveled up, so we're gonna be evolving after this battle. Looks like my attack is still higher than my special attack. Looks like my special attack is staying right down where it was. It didn't even go up any. Another Pidgey. Come on. Throw something new at me. So yeah, I'm probably gonna show this trainer and like maybe another. 2 others, whatever. Okay. You're mean. Okay. What Aqua Toys is evolving? Bottom. Bottom. Alright. So it looks like our War Turtle is now with us. Congratulations, your Aqua Toys evolved into War Turtle. Alright. So now we have a War Turtle. I want to check and see how much his stats changed after he evolved. His attack went up a little, his defense went up a lot. So did his special defense. Special attack went up too. Everything went up. His speed is awesome now. His defense and special defense are the same. Not bad. Okay. So I'm probably not going to be showing most of the battles on this route, just because that would be way too many. Nothing here. So I'll probably cut most of the battles out, alright guys? Hey, I saw you in Viridian Forest. Okay, wow. In the middle of that battle, his Weedle poisoned me, so now I have to use my antidote on my Squirtle, or my War Turtle. Whatever. And a potion, why not? Okay, who's up next? You. Hi, I like shorts. They're delightfully comfy and easy to wear. Okay, so apparently that guy likes shorts. My War Turtle also evolved to level 17 in that battle, so racking up the levels. More trainers. Like 4 more, dang. Are you a trainer? Let's get with it right away. Get with what? Okay, looks like we have three more trainers. I'll show this battle down here, just because I want to. Hey, you're not wearing shorts, what's wrong with you? I don't know, dude, what's wrong with you? What's wrong with you? Sparrow, level 14. It's like the only Pokemon he has. I'm also running out of PP for my water gun. There is a PC center before Mount Moon, thank goodness, but I don't know if I'll have enough PP of water gun to get through Mount Moon. I might have to use something else. Tackle actually is pretty strong just because my Squirtle, War Turtle, I keep calling him that, just because my War Turtle has a strong attack over strong attack, over strong special attack is what I'm trying to say. And level 18. See, he has 33 attack and 25 special attack. So, kind of a significant difference. Lost. Okay. I kind of want to check if my attacks are... Okay, it looks like this is a physical attack, of course. I can't tell if, I think Water Gun and Bubble are special attacks, but I'm not sure. I think Water Gun might be a physical attack. Hey, I never knew you could, switch your moves around like that. I never knew that. It's pretty cool. I was thinking about, like, a few minutes ago that I wanted to switch them around for some reason, but now I can, I guess. Okay, now we have to head all the way back around over here. Wow. Another trainer. That look you gave me, it's so intriguing. Okay, we're done with that trainer now. And one more trainer. I believe there's, yeah, two. Whatever. Two more trainers, not that bad. I'll battle you with the Pokemon I just caught. Okay, so Wartortle's about to be level 19, which is, like, extremely high-leveled for this point in the game. Well, not extremely, but kind of. It's almost like I'm on a solo run, like, because I haven't caught any other Pokemon. I'm going to catch a Pokemon in Mount Moon, so don't worry, guys. I only have one Water Gun attack left. I'll show this battle right here. Eek, did you touch me? Yes, I did. I ran into you. One Pokemon, Jigglypuff. Oh, crap. I hope it does not know Sing. Because if it does, then I'm screwed. Aw, dang. Water Gun failed me there. Crap. I think I only have one potion, too. No. Tackle the Jigglypuff. Dang, that was actually pretty good on tackle. Let's do that again. That wasn't even a critical hit. Dang, tackle. Level 19 now. Okay. Okay, bite. Yes. Another physical move. Let's get rid of Bubba. Since we don't need it anymore, we have Water Gun. Bite is going to be like another move I'm going to use a lot because it's physical and I just like Bite a lot. Too bad they don't have Crunch in this game. I don't think they do. That's it? Why, yes it is. Route 4 is at the foot of Mount Moon. Well, duh, we're on Route 4 right now. I think you can find Jigglypuff in the grass right there if you like, check or whatever. I don't think this guy's a trainer. Whew, I better take a rest. Groan. Why did you say groan? That tunnel from Cerulean takes a lot out of you. And yes, it does. Mount Moon is going to be pretty long and not boring, but it's going to be pretty action-packed and, like, it's just going to be long. That's all. I don't know. Heal up our Pokemon, and that guy in the top left corner of the Pokemon Center, if you pay him $500, he'll give you a Magikarp. This is probably one of the worst deals that you can do. Hello there, laddie. I've got a deal for you. I'll let you have a Sacred Mad Pokemon, a Magikarp, just for $500. So you'll buy it, am I right? No. No? You say no? I'm only doing this as a favor to you. So yeah, I mean, I guess it's not the worst, like, idea in the world if, you want to train the Magikarp to be a Gyarados or something, but other than that, there's no point. Team Rocket attacks Trillion citizens. Not a day goes by without Team Rocket being in the news. I'm not going to read the newspaper just because I don't want to. Let's see. I think we'll save Mount Moon for next episode, alright guys? So, in the next episode, we're going to go into Mount Moon, okay? And battle Team Rocket and do fun stuff. And then hopefully get out the other side to Krillin City, to the second gym. Alright guys, I'll see you then. Peace out. Bye-bye now.